एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू DIY विद AJ। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू मेक अ पोस्टमैन डॉल आउट ऑफ न्यूज़पेपर। सो हियर इज द वीडियो फॉर यू। फॉर मेकिंग दिस न्यूज़पेपर डॉल, हियर आई एम टेकिंग अ रेक्टेंगुलर पीस ऑफ न्यूज़पेपर एंड आई एम जस्ट यूजिंग द एंड ऑफ एन ओल्ड पेंट ब्रश। यू कैन यूज एनी थिंग लाइक अ वायर और इवन अ स्टिक विल डू द थिंग। And then just roll it into thin rolls or strips of the newspaper. These strips we need 5, 2 for the hands, 2 for the legs and 1 for the neck. The neck strip will be very thin. And now I'm taking a rectangular sheet of paper, that is the thickness is around 2 inches or 3 centimeters. And with this I'll make the muscles of our limbs. Just start rolling it around the main strip and use white glue to close the ends and fix it at its position. And here it is. Similarly, I will do the same thing but leaving a little bit of gap. I am taking a newspaper around 3 cm wide and then just rolling it around. Remember, you have to leave at least 1 centimeter of gap or 1 finger width of gap so that it will act as a joint and our figure will be it will allow a lot of movement to our figure that we are going to create, that is our doll. After making all these 4, now I am making the neck. For neck, I have used a thin strip of newspaper and that I am rolling it in the middle section. How much thickness you need for the neck according to your doll you can decide, and just close everything together. Now for the body, I have used cardboard. I have just cut it in the shape of rectangle and I have cut multiple pieces so that when we stack them together it will be giving a thick volume to the figure. Same thing goes for the face. And for the hand and feet, I have just drawn the structure and just cut it out from the cardboard. Now we will stick the pieces of the face and the body together. Here I am using white glue. You can use glue gun, but glue gun is not so strong. So I always prefer white glue for these kind of projects. Same thing I'll do with the body. I'll just stick it. And now you can see how thick it is. Now we will start adding the limbs. For adding the limbs, you need to make a hole and just widen it out. Now take the limb that here I am taking the leg part and try to insert it. Here it is very long, so I am just cutting a little bit extra. Now add a dollop of glue and then insert your limb part so that it will allow movement. Again, do the process, make the hole and add the little bit of glue and then add the limb. This process is quite easy. In the same manner, we will add the hands. Here, the hands are done. As you can see, it is allowing a lot of movements like a real body. And now for the neck as well. For the neck, if you don't know how to make the thin newspaper strip, you can even use a straw or a plastic straw, little bit hard material. Now insert the neck and now we will attach the head. For attaching the head, we will repeat the same thing. Take the head, make a hole in the center carefully and now cut out the extra part, use the glue and insert the head. Simple. And here the skeleton of our figure is ready. Now I will just attach the limbs the hands and the feet with glue. And I hope it will turn out right. All right. I'm making this first time myself. So After attaching the hand, I will just attach this tiny feet. Can you see so much? They are so small and tiny and so cute. Okay, so I have attached all of them, and by mistake I have attached them in the wrong way. So after attaching, you can see here how it looks. And I am taking an air dry clay. You can use any kind of clay, homemade paper clay, air dry clay, epoxy clay, or polymer clay will not work. You can use paper mache clay. That will be of it will give a great texture. So here I am using the clay and just covering the head. Rest of the body parts we don't need to cover because it will be inside the clothes. So I'm just covering the head portion and little bit of neck portion, and I'm just trying to use the clay very minimum and give the shape. After giving the shape, now I'm just attaching the nose. A nose is a very cute little triangular. I'm just using my finger to give the shape of the nose. And for smoothing out the clay, because it is looking very rough, you can use water. Here I am using little bit of clay to give the cheek some muscle, and I am just in between I am just smoothing it out with water so that it will not look so textured. And now just add little bit small ears. One ear is done. I think sculpting is the thing that I enjoy the most, I guess. Here is a close-up of how it looks after the sculpting, and I have added some clay over the hands because hands will be out of the clothes and it will be visible. Now after the clay is completely dried out, I am just applying some paint. Here I am using acrylic colors. If you don't have acrylic colors, you can use fabric colors. Now I am making the hairs. For making the hairs, I have just used yarn and combed it with a comb so that it will create a fluff kind of structure, and the texture is very smooth and soft, so it feels like real hair. And I am just using glue to add the hairs in place. This figure, I will add a cap in the middle, so I don't need to cover the whole portion of the hair with the yarn, so I have covered only the side parts. And now just I'm just adding a little bit of mustache because I want to show that this is an old person or a character, like I want to make it a postman. So I'm using this kind of khadi material. This is a rough fabric that was kept at the home, and that only I'm using it. So I have cut a rectangle, and now I will just cover it, cover the sleeves or the hands of the figure doll. And I'm using white glue for this part. If white glue will not work, then you can use fabric glue. If fabric glue will not work, then you can just use sewing needles and thread. Here, after making the full outfit, I have sewed the jacket. As you can see, the stitching marks. Little bit of so cute mustache. I have added tiny beads to give the illusion of buttons. A pant. I have added the buttons or the beads on the side of the sleeves as well, so it will look more real. And the inner part, I have added a white type of khadi material. And off camera, I have made some cute little shoes. And a small specs out of wire. These are the accessories that will give life to the doll. This is the cap that I was talking about. I want to make him a postman. So this is the bag that he uses to carry the letters. And now the letters. I have made a cute love letter, a postal letters, some envelopes. I just want to give lot of accessories to him. And there's a parcel that he can carry. There's a big parcel. I don't know if I can fit it, but maybe I will use it in photo shoot, some newspapers. and now it is the assembly time. First, I will just put on the shoes. The shoes I have made from cardboard, as you can see, and the sides of the shoes I have made from paper and just painted over it. So I am attaching the shoes with glue. I want to make everything fixed or permanent, so I am just attaching everything with glue. Now I am adding the cap. Adding the cap or attaching the cap was the most difficult part because it just kept on falling and falling. Now the bag, I am adding little bit of fluff inside the bag so it will look a little bit filled up. And at the opening of the bag, I am just attaching the letter so it will look like the letters are coming out of the bag, or means aesthetic purposes, I guess. So carefully attaching the letters, and now the one letter I will attach to his other hand so that he will carry. And I want to give this parcel in his hand, but first I have to give the bag. After hanging the bag with his shoulder, I am just attaching the bag and the parcel so he will hold it. That was the look I was going for, and I guess it looks fine. Here's the photos. This is the final look of my postman, and I'm just loving it, guys. And if you also like it, then please give a like and subscribe.